hello everyone, welcome on your Pedia. Myself Ishita. Today I'm going to discuss with you some of the do's and don'ts that you have to keep in your mind while you're preparing for the interviews, especially for the campus placement interviews. As we all know that the behavior and presentation during the time of interview is very important. How we behave, how we present ourselves, how we portray our personality and how we portray our attitude is the major thing that we have to keep in the mind while preparing for the interviews. How we carry that 15 to 30 minutes, that entire 15 to 30 minutes when we are sitting in front of the panel members, we should know how to sit, how to stand, how to behave, because our overall personality will show the panel members whether we are good for that interview or not. Knowledge of some questions should not be the criteria. As we all know that knowledge is a very important part of academics, but only knowledge is not the major criteria which is seen during the time of interviews. That too, it is your personality, it is your attitude which is seen during the time of the interviews. Even if we are not aware regarding any of the question, if we don't know what is the answer, then also we should be confident, and with that confidence we should carry on with the interview. Let us discuss some of the do's that we have to follow during the time of the interview. First of all, we have to be very much calm. While we are giving the interview, we have to be very much calm, very much composite. Because if we are calm, that will reflect on our face. Please smile and wish them at first sight. It is very important to sit with a smiling face. Because if we are sitting with a smiling face, that will reflect on our face. That smile will give a good impression. Because as we all know, our first impression is the last impression. If we are giving a good impression at first sight, definitely that will give us an advantage till the end. Be confident. It is very important to be confident. Because if we are sitting with a confident face, with a confident mindset, then definitely we'll crack it on. We'll definitely crack that interview. Be attentive and alert. When the panel member, like 4 to 5 panel members are sitting in front of you, any of the panel member can ask you a question. So it is very important for you to be attentive and alert so that you can listen to the question carefully and you can answer it very carefully. Sit properly. Our posture defines ourselves. It is very important to sit with the right posture, sit properly in a maintained decorum and in maintained order. Maintain proper eye contact with the panel members. It is very important to maintain a proper eye contact with the panel members, because if you are seeing here and there, that will create a very bad impression. If you are directly having an eye contact with the panel member, it will be easy for you as well as the panel member, as you are answering to the question, so it will be more clear to the panel member. Listen question carefully before answering. It is very important to listen to the question carefully before you answer it. Sometimes it happens like you are not able to hear the question properly. In that case, try to ask that question again, but don't give a wrong answer to that question. Seek clarification in case questions is not clear. As we discussed in earlier point, that if you are not able to hear the question properly, it is better to ask that question again so that you get a clarity of that question. Once you'll get the clarity of that question, you can give it very nicely. Answer to the point as per the requirement. It is very important to answer to the point. Your answer should be short, it should be crisp, and it should be to the point. It is very important that you should give a short answer. Stretching that answer, taking it long, can hamper your performance only. So it is very important to give a short and crisp answer. Wear proper formal dress in which you feel comfortable also. Many of the candidates have this question in mind that whether I should wear the formal dress or not. Yes, if you wear a formal dress, that will give you an advantage. But on the other hand, that formal dress should be comfortable for you as well. So you should know how to carry that formal dress. Carrying that in a good way is definitely a good part on your end. Maintain proper body language during the time of the interview. As we discussed, your posture defines yourselves. It is very important that you should have a good posture, you should sit properly, you should stand properly, you should behave properly at that point of time. Because these basic table manners will give a good image of yours in front of the panel members. Be positive and talk positive. If we are positive from within, that will definitely create a positive surroundings around us. So be positive from within, sit with a positive mindset, so everything will go on positive with you. Now we can discuss the don'ts that we have to keep in mind while we are preparing for that interview. Do not fake, be yourself. Bluffing during the type of HR interview can cause a very difficult situation for you. So guys, it is very important to be very much neutral. You should speak truth. You should say what is right. Don't bluff in front of the panel members. They will definitely catch you. Once they will catch you, definitely you are not going to crack that interview, and that will create a very bad image in front of the panel members. So say what is truth. Just speak it up and speak it very nicely. What truth you know about that? What are the facts? And everything should be very much true. Don't be nervous and don't lose your confidence. We all know that during the time of interview, we get panic. We are not able to get what we have to do. But it is very important not to lose your confidence and be very much confident during the time of the interview. If you are confident, if you are going with a confident mindset, then definitely it will help you till the end. Because the confident mindset will help you give the best interview on at that particular period of time. Avoid talking a lot and unnecessary. It is very important to talk in a limit. Give your interview to the best, but try give it in a short and very crisp manner. As we discussed earlier, it is very important to answer in short. So don't say what is unnecessary. Keep it to the point. Keep it what you want to say. Don't sit in lethargic posture. It is very important to sit properly. These are some of the major points that you have to keep in your mind. Because you're sitting, you're standing, that will create an image of yours in front of the panel members. So it is very important to sit in a very good posture, very active posture. Try not to sit in lethargic posture. Don't be very much serious. That seriousness will definitely reflect on your face, and it will create a very bad image. So it is very important to sit with a very smiling face. Don't show that seriousness on your face. Show that you are very much calm, you are very much confident, and you are sitting with a smiling face. Don't be late to reach venue. If you are late to reach venue, definitely you will panic. So to avoid that panic situation, try to reach the venue before time, as it will help you to get to know what all are the prevailing surroundings at that point of time, so that it is easy for you to adapt yourself according to that particular surroundings. Don't overeat. Everything goes on very nicely, but if we overeat, that will create a very bad health and that will hamper our interview. Definitely, if you overeat, that will create a unhealthy situation for you, and you will not be able to perform nicely within your interview. So it is very important to eat healthy. Eat less so that your interview goes very well. Eat healthy less, but yeah, according to yourself, you should see what all you can digest, what all you cannot. So please eat properly according to your body. Don't read related to subject matter. During the time of interview, it is you as a person, you, what is your personality, what is your attitude, more than what is your subject. Your subject is a secondary part. But in that particular interview, you have to overall show you what you are. So it is very important to keep that subject matter, subject related things at the second priority. On the first priority, you should keep yourself, your posture, your attitude, your personality. Because your overall attitude and personality will define yourself. Don't provide wrong data if you're not sure. If you're not sure regarding a particular question, don't provide a wrong data. Don't speak it up. Don't say unnecessary, but make sure that you don't say the wrong data. If you're not clear about the question, ask it again. If you're not clear about what you have to say, just keep it concise and say whatever you know about that question. Don't speak the wrong data or unnecessary data. If you're not sure, still you want to answer, seek the permission. It is very important that if you're not sure about a question, but then also you have to speak it up, then ask the permission of panel members. It is very important to ask the permission of panel members before saying anything, any statement or anything that is asked to you regarding a particular question. Don't judge yourself and others. It is very important not to judge yourself or others. If someone has already given the interview, don't be very much interested to ask a particular person regarding their interview, because what you will portray in your interview, because you cannot behave like others. So it is very important not to judge anyone. Give your best, let others give their best. So you have to be yourself in that interview. Don't judge others related to any particular point. Be what you are and like crack the interview according to your personality. Don't expect anything, be neutral. It is very important not to expect anything before going into that interview hall or interview room. When you are going to that room, be very much neutral. You are going to crack that interview or not totally depends upon that 15 to 30 minutes. But preparing yourself before that interview, what is going to happen will cause like a little bit harm to your performance. So it is very important to be neutral before you enter that interview hall. Don't compare yourself with other candidates like your college, your age, your marks. Everyone is unique and everyone is different. We have to keep this thing in our mind. Don't think like anyone else is from a particular college, he can do better, his age is good, he can do better. No. What you are, you have to portray yourself. Maybe your college is not that good college, but you can perform better from that other person. So be confident, keep that confident on yourself. Keeping everything aside, that is your marks, that is your college, that is your age. This is your personality. This is your attitude which will help you to perform good. Don't judge anyone like what college, what age, be it what, like anything that particular person holds. It is you that you have to portray your personality. So overall, the crux of this point is, you have to be yourself in that interview. You have to perform your best. Don't think that what others are doing, their age, their college, they have to keep with themselves. But you have to perform your best. Don't use mobile phone even if you have access to it. Try not to use your mobile phones if you enter that interview hall. Keep that phone aside for that 15 to 20 minutes, because that will definitely distract you. And distraction during the time of interview is not good. Try keep your phone aside and just give your best in that interview. Don't take too much things with you to the venue. It is very important not to carry a lot of stuff with you like during the time of the interview, because your mindset will be like, my material is safe or not. So carry a very little material with you. So friends, this was a video related to the do's and don'ts that you have to practice during the time of the interview. I will definitely make some of the parts, like elaborative parts of some of the like points that you are not able to get in this interview. So we'll definitely make a good videos, a descriptive videos regarding these particular points. So these were some of the points, definitely if you will keep in your mind, that will help you crack the interview in the best manner. Thank you so much. Have a good day.